1922, we're in Columbus, Ohio, at the Horseshoe, to see what should be a great football game. Let's head down to the coin toss now, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 10. Brought down at the 22. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. At the 31. From their own 31-yard line. Second down. Great coverage, and it's intercepted. He's at the 40. And down he goes at the 33. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33. And they get nice yardage on that run. That's a gain of 4 on one play. Check 3. That makes it 7-6. Slings it. And he's taken down at the 15-yard line.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Run play and he'll lose yards. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
From the 17-yard line, it's second down. Throws incomplete, knocked away. Becoming the 12th man, the crowd is always into it here. And he's level at the 24-yard line. Fourth and long here after the sack. Bowling Green could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance. And it's good.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
3-0, Bowling Green. Davidson has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. And he's tackled at the 23-yard line. Bowling Green's looking right now like they've got all three phases working for him so far, Kirk.
Yep, it's early, but they are in control of this game. The defense seems to have a very good feel for what they're doing out there. The offense moved the ball down the field. Special teams, everything right now is really in sync for this team.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
So much in football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
tackled after a decent run up the gut.
That brings him second and five.
From their own 28-yard line. Second down. And they make the stop around the 31-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll bring up third and two.
From the tailback.
That shows you why he's such a weapon as a ball carrier. Good game for the offense.
From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That brings him second and five.
Midfield. He's taken down around the 40-yard line. So another run and another first down.
And it's time for the defense to buckle down. They need to start hitting the gaps and getting into the backfield.
First and 10, ball on the 40. It all doesn't get there. They went with a long ball, but he put too much arm into it.
It looked like he overestimated the speed of his receiver on that one.
He makes his way to about the 32. Here's the eighth play of the series. He's at the 20. Keeps his eye on it, makes the catch.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
First and 10. Ball on the 18-yard line. For a nice game. Here's play number 10 on the drive. They'll bring him down at about the 9-yard line.
That'll make it third and one.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Man, it's always a plus if you're able to pick up the first down with the running game.
We're at the 12th play of the drive.
This is what an offensive lineman hopes for. An opportunity to impose his will on the defense.
Nice play to take the three-point lead here early in the first quarter. The question now is if they can build off this momentum later in the game.
He makes the PAT. A 12-play, 77-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart up. It can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Ohio State ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Fires out to his wideout, and he's tackled at the 40-yard line. And on the throw, he caught it, and they push him out at the 43. Folks, that's the end of quarter number one, and we got a pretty good ball game on our hands so far. 7-3, Ohio State. And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set to start the second quarter. There's the strike complete. Brought down at the 28-yard line. And they got him for a loss.
The D-line did a good job of nullifying out the blocks up front, and that allowed the linebacker to roam free and make the tackle in the backfield.
So it's second and 14. Ball on the 33-yard line. The catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. And they lose a couple there.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Tackle made around the 15-yard line. That makes it first and 10. The 17, and the linebacker comes up and makes a big stop.
This is textbook. This is how you're supposed to play against the run.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Just throws this one away. They'll line it up again on third down. Hook up on that one.
The quarterback has to be very careful, Brad, of throwing the football into a position where the wide receiver has a chance to get his head taken off. He threw the ball there, and it made it easy for the defender to be able to separate him from the ball.
Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 10. Across the 30. He gets hit out of bounds at the 32-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Ohio State up a point. He's to the 40. Makes it out to about the 43. First
First down, 10 to go.
Ball on the 43. Inside handoff. He fights forward to about the 43.
No gain. That makes it second and 10.
From their own 43-yard line. Second down. He gets to about the 41-yard line. Little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 30. Tackled after a decent pickup.
Is up one. And he came down with it. What a catch. And he adds the extra point. A nice six-play, 68-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So our score, 14-6. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish, whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball, but they're not finishing the drive. They got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. So it's second and 13. Ball on the 22. Hit before he can go anywhere. And this crowd is going absolutely crazy. Now he pitches it. He's pushed out of bounds at the 37-yard line.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
From their own 37-yard line. First down. The Falcons will use their first time out of the half.
Nothing flashy at all. But now, that first down marker is a lot closer.
Around the 43-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. First down.
Four down. Mike five. Ready.
Easy.
Lucky 95.
Throws it to the outside. Complete. What a catch. And he's taken down around the 22-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 21 yards. First down.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And they make the stop at the 21. Five wide. Gets rid of this one.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
It's the ninth play of the drive. He's in trouble. Going for it all to the end zone. Leaps picked off.
Really nice cover skill shown here this time. That's exactly what you want to see from your young corner.
From their own 20-yard line. First down. Ohio State is up by 8. He's out to the 30. Gains his way to the 36-yard line. Pressure, wants to go long, and does. He's hit and taken down. And the wideout gets a chance to show what he can do.
Oh, he sure does, and he doesn't disappoint either. Great athletic ability.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. He is drilled at the 28. The Buckeyes use their second timeout.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 28-yard line, it's second down. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves them with a first and goal.
Well, that's a big play by the offense. And I got to tell you, as a defense coordinator, you're blitzing and you're taking some chances. And it's one thing to blitz and to get to the quarterback and everybody high fives and gets excited. But if you blitz and you don't get home, as they say, which means hitting the quarterback, you're leaving your defensive backs one-on-one in coverage. And if you don't get to that quarterback, you're facing a talented quarterback like this.
Touchdown, Ohio State. PAT. It was a five-play, 79-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The offense comes out to start this drive, and they're hoping for a better result as they threw a pick on their last possession.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
He's taken down around the 50-yard line. So they pick up big yards on the option keeper.
I thought he's going to break that one for a touchdown. You couldn't draw that up any better.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball in the 50, so we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. He's going to go for the home run. And a great catch downfield. converts the extra point. We've played a half. Ohio State leads it 21-13. All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense.
He's got his receiver with nobody around him. Inside the 30. The 10. Touchdown, Falcons. They need to tie it up here, and that's exactly why they're going for two.
Slam, slam, slam. Let's go.
Caught it, and the conversion is good. Bowling Green gets set to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 10. And he just got drilled.
Wow, close game here. Up and down the field with both these offenses matching what the others done.
Well, it's fun to watch each offense get an opportunity to go out and make plays. And you're right, you almost feel as if one offense feels challenged and has to be able to bounce back, and they've done that.
They'll bring him down around the 17-yard line.
When this guy gets his arms around the ball carrier, I don't care who it is, he's not getting away.
Second down and 14. Ball on the 17-yard line. And he's tackled around the 29-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line. From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. And they hit him in the backfield.
Loss of 3 on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Him hard at the 41. First and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That brings him second and 5.
He makes his way to about the 18. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
He goes up and gets it. It's a touchdown. splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that same strategy, or will they start to lean a little bit more on their ground game?
Got an opening!
And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a gain of 7.
Man left, man left!
That'll bring up second and 2.
Here's an opening. He's at midfield. Inside the 30. To the 10. He scores. What a play.
Wow, he looked like a running back out there. And that's just what you want when you're calling the option.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. He's to the 10. They'll bring him down at the 21-yard line.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Brought down right around the 24-yard line.
3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
It's second and 7. Ball on the 24.
The 49. Here comes the pressure with a quick throw. Almost intercepted.
That was a nice play. Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 49. He's tackled at the 35.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 35. Tackle at the 22.
Thank you.
job by the running back, and that's a gain of 9.
That brings up second and 1.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and 1. In there, got it, touchdown. Make it 3 passes for touchdowns.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
Talk about a great catch. When you've got playmakers who can make catches like that, it can really make a good quarterback great. And he adds the extra point. Kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Throws to the receiver, incomplete.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
From their own 25-yard line, second down. 5 guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun.
Disappointed. This crowd is amazing. Going deep. Got it to the senior. The 10. Touchdown, Bowling Green.
The extra point to tie this game up. He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 10. Oh, man, he took him down hard. That's the end of 3, and get ready for an action-packed fourth quarter with this game all tied up. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here.
Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground. Well, he tried to thread the needle with that pass.
Well, here the quarterback makes a poor decision throwing into coverage. He needs to look at his progression and find the second and third receiver.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 14. Some daylight. And they make the stop at the 29-yard line. He's under some heat. Throws out and through his hands. Their own 29-yard line. Second down. He's to the 40, and he's taken down
at about the 43-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
First and 10, ball on their own 43.
tripped up for the sack.
The offensive line has to at least slow the guy down a little bit. He was in there in no time.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 47.
Tight end left, tight end left. Four down. 85, I'm coming.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Samuel will take the receiver. That makes it fourth and long.
Miller is the deep man awaiting the return. He gets it away. This is a really nice punt. And he's taken down at the 27.
What a day this receiver's putting together, Kirk.
Well, I don't think there's any question. He's getting the best right now of this group of defensive backs. You know, he's a tough matchup physically, one-on-one. And he's got good hands. And he battles for every single throw that the quarterback puts up into the air. So far, so good for this receiver.
And the funny thing is, he's racked up all the yards on just 5 catches.
And down he goes to the 38-yard line. Throws complete. He's got space to work. He's taken down at the 20-yard line.
First down.
Carries the ball for a nice gain. A gain of about 4 yards on the draw. Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab.
Number 74 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it 35.
From the 16-yard line, third down. The intimidation factor is definitely here when you're playing in this stadium. And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. Bowling Green is ready to kick it away. He just drills this one. He's to the 10. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game.
Strike to his receiver, no good.
Smith is the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
It's second and 10. Ball on their own 19.
Mike 27. Run.
Up the middle for a nice game.
That's a D5 on the play. Third down.
Man left. Four down. Hey, check Mike 27.
Hey,
down after a nice run up the middle. From their own 30-yard line, first down. Tackled after a decent pickup. Just under three to go in regulation. Makes it to the 44. From their own 44-yard line, it's first down. Gets to about the 47-yard line.
That's a gain of three on the play. That'll make it second and seven.
Weber, again, he's losing ground. They'll bring him down at the 40-yard line.
It's a great play by the defense, but you know, it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field.
Check four, check four.
Hey, check my car.
And he's tackled at about the 35. This is the 10th play of this drive. Just over a minute left. Gains his way to the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, first down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That makes it second and six.
We're at the 12th play of the drive. Up the middle for a nice run.
Well, that's the fifth first down for this offense on this drive. The defense, you can look at it. Hands are on their knees, hands are on their hips. They're looking tired. This offense right now has this defense exactly where they want it.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. So a 13-play, 80-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. They're lined up to kick, and they might just kick it short and prevent a long return. He really got a hold of that kick.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Bowling Green still got a chance here. They might come up short, but not for lack of trying.
Well, I've been impressed with this team the entire way. Now we're going to really find out what they're made out of. With the game on the line, late in the ball game, how do you go out and execute?
This has been a great game, and it all comes down to this. Who can prevail, the offense or the defense? We're about to find out who's going to win it in this drive. Quick strike to the back, no good. From their own 25-yard line, second down. Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down right around the 30. The Falcons will use their first time out of the half. Can't hear a thing down there. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Five wide. An unbelievable stop when they had to have it on fourth down, and that should be the football game. This might be it. They've got the lead, but if they add to it, they know they've got a victory. Ohio State holds a four-point lead. Deep ball, laying it out there. Oh, what an interception. Big interception by this defense, and now they hand it over to their offense with a chance to seize the momentum of this game. From their own 20-yard line, first down. And it all comes down to this. One last chance to throw one up and see if somebody can bring it down and win the game. Going long. It's going the other way. Tackle made at the 29.
One.
Ohio State 42, Bowling Green 38. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.